so. Last name first and the city in which you reside.
Come along. Daniels, Judy, Boston. Right over here, please. Fry, Sally, Chicago.
Thank you.
Baker, Mary, Detroit.
Thank you.
Bailey, Martha, Memphis.
Right over here.
Carmichael, Lucy, Angelus, Loss.
Over here, please. All right, you two girls will occupy bunk 1A and 1B. And you two girls will occupy bunk 2A and 2B. And you two girls will occupy...
I think one of our aircraft is missing.
Where is Miss Tilford? Carol Tilford?
Coming!
Here I am. Carol Tilford?
I'm sorry I'm late.
Where do you come from, Carol?
North Platte, Nebraska.
Thank you. You two girls would be occupying bunk 3A and 3B.
Thank you.
All right, girls. Girls, you can all unpack now and get acquainted.
Here, let me help you.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm Lucy Carmichael.
Oh, glad to meet you.
I'm sure glad we're bunking together.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, Carol, look at this view.
What's the matter? What are we doing way up here?
Way up here? We're just on the fourth floor.
I know it sounds silly, but I've got this phobia about high places. I don't know what you call it.
Well, fear of high places, that's called hydrophobia. You've got that phobia. How come you want to be an airline stewardess?
Well, my mama always told me that if you have a fear, the best way to overcome it is to face up to it.
Oh, well, that's a wonderful attitude, and I certainly admire your courage. Come on, let's unpack. Carol?
Yeah?
What did you do in North Platte?
Oh, I was an usherette in a movie theater, but I had to quit.
Why?
I couldn't go up in the balcony.
I worked in the bank, but I took a leave of absence. That way, if I don't make out here, I always have something to go back to, you know.
Gee, I hope we both make it. Yeah. Just think of all the exciting places we'll get to visit.
Yeah, and all the exciting people the stewardesses get to meet. You know, big executives and movie stars and sports celebrities and... Gee, I might even meet Mr. Wright.
Who's Mr. Wright?
Oh, well, that's just a name I have, you know, for... Well, you know how girls always want to meet that right guy.
Well, I sure hope you meet your Mr. Wright.
Yeah, well, thanks. I hope you get over your fear of high places.
Me too.
Hey, I know what I can do to help you.
What?
I'm going to let you have the top bunk.
Gee, Lucy, you're a peach.
Come on, get up there.
Now?
Yeah, right now.
I
go ahead.
Really
no, give it a try. Yeah, I know, but you give it a try.
I
now.
Don't think
come
I
on,
can...
no, come on.
Now, in serving meals, speed, precision, write it down. Speed, precision, and teamwork are of the utmost importance. I have an automatic timer here, and Miss Gray and Miss Jackson are going to show you how six passengers can be served an order of grapefruit in precisely 37 seconds.
Holy cow!
If you girls would kindly turn your chairs around into the mock-up position. You girls over here, just pick up your chair, run right along. Let's move now. Nice straight lines, girls. Hurry on there. All right, the passengers are in position. You may be seated. May I remind you that is six passengers in precisely 37 seconds. Ready? Go! Enough, girls. You get the idea. We will repeat this teamwork exercise using two of our trainees. We will begin with Lucy and Carol.
Which one you want me?
I'll
do it.
All right.
Girls, please.
And how well you do on this flight determines whether or not you get your wings.
Roger.
Well, here's your flight manual. Goodbye and good luck.
Goodbye, Miss Cavanaugh.
Goodbye, Miss Cavanaugh. Look at the kitchen.
Cute little galley.
Oh, it's just darling.
Isn't this thrilling?
Yeah, and you know something? I may meet my Mr. Wright on my very first flight.
Oh, I hope so.
Yeah, I'm so proud of you, Carrie. You don't seem the least bit nervous.
Well, you know what I think it is?
What?
I think it's the uniform.
Yeah, that's the spirit.
You know, I just can't wait to take off.
You're kidding.
No, get up in that wild blue yonder and...
Repairman.
What are you repairing?
An ashtray.
I don't like the sound of that.
Just an ashtray.
Yeah, well, he's got an awful lot of tools there for just an ashtray.
Now,
I'm getting off.
Carol, now listen here. Now listen to me. The wings that go with that uniform that you're so proud of are the wings of an eagle, not a chicken. Remember our motto.
At Globe World, flying is for people, not for the birds.
All right, now put yourself together.
All right.
Let's get ready for the passengers.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Oh, welcome to Globe World Airlines.
Oh, yes, make yourself comfortable and relax.
Remember that the people serving you are the finest trained in the whole world.
Oh, and we know just how you feel.
Yes.
So if there's anything we can do to take your mind flight.
Help you enjoy the flight. Like a magazine, coffee, tea, or milk.
Or a pillow to put over your eyes.
I'm the pilot.
Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines.
Welcome aboard
Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard. Oh, hey there, musicians. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Oh, welcome aboard. You to your seat, Mr. Brennan.
Right this way.
Yes, right this way, sir. Yes, here's your seat, sir, right here.
Oh, thank you.
Perhaps you'd like to sit next to the window, Mr. Wright. I mean, Mr. Brennan.
I believe that seat is reserved for another passenger.
You just go ahead and sit there. When the other passenger comes, make out like you're asleep.
I'm sure I'll be comfortable here.
Oh, well, to make you real comfortable, I'll turn on the air conditioner.
Would you like me to take your jacket?
Oh, no, don't bother.
It's no bother at all.
No, no.
Well,
no,
Chrissy.
Not at all. Relax and be nice and comfortable. Yeah. You better fasten your seatbelt in case you fall asleep or anything. Now, is there anything I can get you? Coffee, tea, or meat? Or milk?
No, thanks.
Just let me make you a little bit more comfortable. Put a little heavy on the pillow, huh? And we don't want you to catch cold from that nasty old air conditioner. You up when we get to Chicago. Fasten your seatbelts, please. Fasten your seatbelts. You're all right now. Fasten your seatbelts. Fasten your seatbelts, please. Fasten your seatbelts. Ever, Mr. Wright.
Stewardess?
Yes, sir.
All your passengers aboard and accounted for?
Yes, sir.
Passengers all aboard, Captain. You can proceed to runway 7. Here's your flight announcements.
Thank you.
We're ready for takeoff.
Yes, sir.
Are we taking off?
Yes, sir. I'll secure the door, sir. Now, what does it say for us to do next? Good afternoon,
ladies and gentlemen. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines, flight 215 to Chicago. Our pilot and crew would like to acquaint you with the flight pattern for today. Our cruising speed will be approximately 500 miles an hour.
That's cruising!
We are currently flying at an altitude of 32,000 feet. Mr. Brennan. Mr. Brennan. Wake up. Time for lunch.
No, thanks.
Oh, now, you really should eat something.
I have a luncheon engagement in Chicago.
Oh. Gee, I bet you hate going to Chicago.
Why?
Well, you know, being away from the family. Most passengers feel very bad about leaving their wife and kids.
I'm not married.
Oh. Well, maybe you'll meet somebody nice in Chicago.
I'm going there on business.
Oh. Well, perhaps you'll meet someone nice on the way to Chicago.
I had no idea you stewardesses took such a personal interest in your passengers.
Oh, yes, we do. Indeed, we do. tell me, what do you do, Mr. Brennan?
I'm vice president in charge of personnel for my company.
Oh, you look like a man who would be in charge of a lot of people. Tell me, what company are you with?
Globe World Airlines.
You're with this airline?
Yes. And right now, you're 11 minutes late in serving lunch.
Yes, sir, right away, sir. What's for lunch?
We start with grapefruit.
Good, we're in luck. Lunch! Flight manual say we should do now.
Let's see. We serve the drinks. We serve the lunch.
Yeah.
Oh, now we're supposed to show the movie.
Oh, yes. Okay, I'll do it. Ladies and gentlemen, Globe World Airlines is pleased to provide for your entertainment a screening of our scheduled movie. Something wrong, Mr. Brennan?
Yes. Is this any way to run an airline?
Boy, there's a line. I'm sorry about the film, but
this is our first flight.
When your supervisor gets this report, it'll be your last.
Oh, you can't do that now. I was just getting to like it.
I can understand about you being upset, but couldn't you give us another chance?
I'm sorry, girls, but because of you, we're going to get a lot of complaints. Now, we promise our passengers entertainment on these flights, and they look forward to that entertainment.
Just because the movie broke down, that doesn't mean they can't have entertainment.
What do you mean?
Well, back home in North Platte, Nebraska, we make our own entertainment.
Hey, that's a wonderful idea.
I'll go ask those musicians to help.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
well,
we have musicians.
I don't know if
that... Mr. Brandon, don't you worry about a thing. Don't you worry about it. You just go in and sit down and relax. Now, don't you worry. Will they help us? Ladies and gentlemen, a lot of airlines offer you movies and stereo music to listen to, but Globe World Airlines is the very first to bring you live entertainment.
Hit it, boys! Let us entertain you. And then some new tricks. We're very versatile. That guy with the fancy bow tie and a hat to go with his cravat. You gotta start up each day with a song. Even when things go wrong, you'll feel better. You'll even look better. I'm here to tell you, you'll be a go-getter.
Number!
glad we're bunking together.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, Carol, look at this view.
What's the matter? What are we doing way up here?
Way up here? We're just on the fourth floor.
I know it sounds silly, but I've got this phobia about high places. I don't know what you call it.
Well, fear of high places, that's called hydrophobia. You've got that phobia. How come you want to be an airline stewardess?
Well, my mom... Carol Gilbert?
I'm sorry I'm late.
Where do you come from, Carol?
Oh, North Platte, Nebraska.
Thank you. You two girls would be occupying bunk 3A and 3B.
Thank you.
All right, girls. Girls, you can all unpack now and get acquainted.
Here, let me help you.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm Lucy Carmichael.
Oh, glad to meet you.
As you file in, please identify yourself. Last name first and the city in which you reside.
Come along.
Daniels, Judy, Boston. Right over here, please.
Fry, Sally, Chicago.
Thank you.
Baker, Mary, Detroit.
Thank you.
Bailey, Martha, Memphis.
Right over here.
Angela's loss.
Over here, please. All right, you two girls will occupy bunk 1A and 1B. And you two girls will occupy bunk 2A and 2B. And you two girls will occupy...
I think one of our aircraft is missing.
Where is Miss Tilford? Carol Tilford!
Relax and be nice and comfortable. Yeah. You better fasten your seatbelt in case you fall asleep or anything. Now, is there anything I can get you? Coffee, tea, or meat? Or milk?
No, thanks.
Just let me make you a little bit more comfortable. Put a little heavy on the pillow, huh? And we don't want you to catch cold from that nasty old air conditioner. You up when we get to Chicago. Fasten your seatbelts, please. Fasten your seatbelts. You're all right now. Fasten your seatbelts. Fasten your seatbelts, please. Fasten your seatbelts. Ever, Mr. Wright.
Stewardess?
Yes, sir.
All your passengers aboard and accounted for?
Yes, sir.
Passengers all aboard, Captain. You can proceed to runway 7. Here's your flight announcements.
Thank you.
We're ready for takeoff.
Yes, sir.
Are we taking off?
Yes, sir. I'll secure the door, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard Globe World Airlines,
Flight 215 to Chicago. Our pilot and crew would like to acquaint you with the flight pattern for today. Our cruising speed will be approximately 500 miles an hour.
That's cruising!
We are currently flying at an altitude of 32,000 feet.
Where do you come from, Carol?
North Platte, Nebraska.
Thank you. You two girls would be occupying bunk 3A and 3B.
Thank you.
All right, girls. Girls, you can all unpack now and get acquainted.
Here, let me help you.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm Lucy Carmichael.
Oh, glad to meet you.
I'm sure glad we're bunking together.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, Carol, look at this view.
What's the matter? What are we doing way up here?
Way up here? We're just on the fourth floor.
I know it sounds silly, but I've got this phobia about high places. I don't know what you call it.
Well, fear of high places, that's called hydrophobia. How come you want to be an airline stewardess?
Well, my mama always told me that if you have a fear, the best way to overcome it is to face up to it.
Oh, well, that's a wonderful attitude, and I certainly admire your courage. Come on, let's unpack. Carol?
Yeah?
What did you do in North Platte?
Oh, I was an usherette in a movie theater, but I had to quit.
Why?
I couldn't go up in the balcony.
I worked in a bank, but I took a leave of absence. That way, if I don't make out here, I always have something to go back to, you know.
Yeah. Gee, I hope we both make it. Yeah. Just think of all the exciting places we'll get to visit.
Yeah, and all the exciting people the stewardesses get to meet. You know, big executives and movie stars and sports celebrities and... Gee, I might even meet Mr. Wright.
Who's Mr. Wright?
Oh, well, that's just a name I have, you know, you know how girls always want to meet that right guy.
Well, I sure hope you meet your Mr. Wright.
Yeah, well, thanks. I hope you get over your fear of high places.
Me too.
Hey, I know what I can do to help you.
What?
I'm going to let you have the top bunk.
Gee, Lucy, you're a peach.
Come on, get up there.
Now?
Yeah, right now.
I don't really want
no,
to.
Give it a try. Yeah, I know, but you give it a try.
I just don't think
come
I
on,
can.
No, no, come on.
Now, in serving meals, speed, precision, write it down. Speed, precision, and teamwork are of the utmost importance. I have an automatic timer here, and Miss Gray and Miss Jackson are going to show you how 6 passengers can be served an order of grapefruit in precisely 37 seconds.
Holy cow!
If you girls would kindly turn your chairs around into the mock-up position. You girls over here, just pick up your chair, run right along, let's move now. Nice straight.
And sit there. When the other passenger comes, make out like you're asleep.
I'm sure I'll be comfortable here.
Oh, well, to make you real comfortable, I'll turn on the air conditioner.
Oh, would you like me to take your jacket?
Oh, no, don't bother.
It's no bother at all.
No, no.
Well,
no,
Chrissy.
Not at all. Relax and be nice and comfortable. Yeah. You better fasten your seatbelt in case you fall asleep or anything. Now, is there anything I can get you? Coffee, tea, or meat? Or milk?
No, thanks.
Just let me make you a little bit more comfortable. Put a little heavy on the pillow. And we don't want you to catch cold from that nasty old air conditioner. You up when we get to Chicago. Fasten your seatbelts, please. Fasten your seatbelts. You're all right now. Fasten your seatbelts. Fasten your seatbelts, please. Fasten your seatbelts. Mr. Wright.
Stewardess?
Yes, sir.
All your passengers to the board and accounted for?
Yes, sir.
Passengers all aboard, Captain. You can proceed to runway 7. Here's your flight announcements.
Thank you.
We're ready for takeoff.
Yes, sir.
Are we taking off?
Yes, sir. I'll secure the door, sir.
Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines, flight 215 to Chicago. Our pilot and crew would like to acquaint you with the flight pattern for today. Our cruising speed will be approximately 500 miles an hour.
That's cruising!
We are currently flying at an altitude of 32,000 feet. Mr. Brennan. Wake up. Time for lunch.
No, thanks.
Oh, now, you really should eat something.
I have a luncheon engagement in Chicago.
Oh. Gee, I bet you hate going to Chicago.
Why?
Well, you know, being away from the family. Most passengers feel very bad about leaving their wife and kids.
I'm not married.
Oh. Well, maybe you'll meet somebody nice in Chicago.
I'm going there on business.
Oh. Well, perhaps you'll meet someone nice on the way to Chicago.
I had no idea you stewardesses took such a personal interest in your passengers.
Oh, yes, we do. Indeed, we do. Tell me, what do you do, Mr. Brennan?
I'm vice president in charge of personnel for my company.
Oh, you look like a man who would be in charge of a lot of people. Tell me, what company are you with?
Globe World Airlines.
You're with this airline?
Yes. And right now, you're 11 minutes late in serving lunch.
Yes, sir, right away, sir. What's for lunch?
We start with grapefruit.
Good, we're in luck. Lunch! Flight manual say we should do now.
Let's see. We serve the drinks. We serve the lunch.
Yeah.
Oh, now we're supposed to show the movie.
Oh, yes. Okay, I'll do it. Ladies and gentlemen, Globe World Airlines is pleased to provide for your entertainment a screening of our scheduled movie.
And how well you do on this flight determines whether or not you get your wings.
Roger.
Well, here's your flight manual. Goodbye and good luck.
Goodbye, Miss Cavanaugh.
Goodbye, Miss Cavanaugh. Look at the kitchen.
Cute little galley all our own. Oh, it's just darling.
Isn't this thrilling?
Yeah, and you know something? I may meet my Mr. Wright on my very first flight.
Oh, I hope so.
Yeah, I'm so proud of you, Carrie. You don't seem the least bit nervous.
Well, you know what I think it is?
What?
I think it's the uniform.
Yeah, that's the spirit.
You know, I just can't wait to take off.
You're kidding.
No, get up in that wild blue yonder and... Who are you?
I'm the repairman.
What are you repairing?
An ashtray.
I don't like the sound of that.
Just an ashtray.
Yeah, well, he's got an awful lot of tools there for just an ashtray.
Now,
I'm getting off.
Carol, now listen here. Now listen to me. The wings that go with that uniform that you're so proud of are the wings of an eagle, not a chicken. Remember our motto.
At Globe World, flying is for people, not for the birds.
All right, now put yourself together.
All right.
Let's get ready for the passengers.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Oh, welcome to Globe World Airlines.
Oh, yes, make yourself comfortable and relax.
Remember that the people serving you are the finest trained in the whole world.
Oh, and we know just how you feel.
Yes.
So if there's anything we can do to take your mind off your flight.
Help you enjoy the flight. Like a magazine, coffee, tea, or milk.
Or a pillow to put over your eyes.
I'm the pilot.
Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines.
Flight 215,
welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines.
And how well you do on this flight determines whether or not you get your wings.
Roger.
Well, here's your flight manual. Goodbye and good luck.
Goodbye, Miss Cavanaugh.
Goodbye, Miss Cavanaugh. Look at the kitchen.
Cute little galley all our own.
Thrilling.
Oh, it's just darling.
Isn't this thrilling?
Yeah, and you know something? I may meet my Mr. Wright on my very first flight.
Oh, I hope so.
Yeah, I'm so proud of you, Carrie. You don't seem the least bit nervous.
Well, you know what I think it is?
What?
I think it's the uniform.
Yeah, that's the spirit.
You know, I just can't wait to take off.
You're kidding.
No, get up in that wild blue yonder and... Who are you?
I'm the repairman.
What are you repairing?
An ashtray.
I don't like the sound of that.
Just an ashtray.
Yeah, well, he's got an awful lot of tools there for just an ashtray.
Now,
I'm getting off.
Carol, now listen here. Now listen to me. The wings that go with that uniform that you're so proud of are the wings of an eagle, not a chicken. Remember our motto.
At Globe World, flying is for people, not for the birds.
All right, now put yourself together.
All right.
Let's get ready for the passengers.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Oh, welcome to Globe World Airlines.
Oh, yes, make yourself comfortable and relax.
Remember that the people serving you are the finest trained in the whole world.
Oh, and we know just how you feel.
Yes.
So if there's anything we can do to take your mind off your flight.
Help you enjoy the flight. Like a magazine, coffee, tea, or milk.
Or a pillow to put over your eyes.
I'm the pilot.
Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines.
Flight 215
to Chicago. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard. Oh, hey there, musicians. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard Globe World Airlines. Welcome aboard.
Come right in.
Oh, yes. I'll help you to your seat, Mr. Brennan.
Right this way.
Yes, right this way, sir. Yes, here's your seat, sir, right here.
Oh, thank you.
Perhaps you'd like to sit next to the window, Mr. Wright. I mean, Mr. Brennan.
I believe that
seat is reserved for another passenger.
You just go ahead and sit there. When the other passenger comes, make out like you're asleep.
I'm sure I'll be comfortable here.
Oh, well, to make you real comfortable, I'll turn on the air conditioner.
Would you like me to take your jacket?